get up into her nostrils.
It seems to have a universal relaxing effect.
This week, Mary Midkiff explains how she uses aromatherapy and acupressure with horses.
When my horse sees me coming, he knows that's what he's going to get, and he's like, oh, thank you, Mary.
So get comfortable, kick your boots off, and join me. This is The Horse Show, and I'm Rick Lamb.
Studies have shown that the higher the body temperature, the quicker an athlete reaches fatigue. That's why pro football players use protective padding that's not only shock-absorbing, but lightweight and breathable to allow heat dissipation. Now the same technology is available for your horse. Professionals Choice Air Ride saddle pads are designed with exactly the same material, which allows your horse to remain cool and performing at its maximum while effectively deflecting shock. Try the Air Ride today. Go to profchoice.com and click Rick Lamb.
When customers talk, Richie listens. And the Omni 10 automatic waterer has just what customers want. Extra size and strength, total heat coverage, large access panel, stainless steel trough, and Richie's famous fast refill valve. Like all Richie waterers, the Omni 10 is durable, reliable, and comes with a 10-year warranty. Learn more at richiefount.com. And relax, Richie waters them right.
Years. You don't look any different.
During the World Equestrian Games in Lexington, I caught up with an old friend, Mary Midkiff, who's always doing interesting things with horses.
Mary, I want to catch up with you a little bit about what you've been doing over the past 10 years. It's been way too long since we've talked. You specialize in horsemanship and horses for women. Explain to me that.
Well, I think I might have mentioned this in the 90s, Rick, but it's worth mentioning again that horses and women are like glue. You know, we're in love with each other. There's so much passion between us. And I found that it is backed up by the numbers that 80 to 90% of all horse participants today are girls and women. And they are looking for information, techniques, equipment, and whatever they can find to help them get that relationship that they so deeply want.
10 years ago or so, you were working with a big ball and you were helping women, I guess, overcome balance issues. Was that kind of the plan?
Yeah, that was part of it. It was an ideal teaching aid as well, because you have to sit on the ball and then have elastic reins in your hand and another person, and you kind of act as though you're sitting on a moving object and finding your balance and learning to have an independent seat, learning to be soft in your hands, and then talking and thinking and moving separately while you're still bouncing. So there were so many wonderful qualities to that. And then it also, yes, serves to be a great exercise tool. So yeah, I'm still doing the ball thing for sure.
I bet a lot of people use that and they discover muscles they didn't know they had the next day in that core area.
Yes, and the core area is so key to riding because it does support the back muscles and it allows the limbs to be free and independent. And so you don't get those muscle ligament tendon issues if your core is nice and supportive.
You've gone into some other areas with your holistic approach. Talk to me about that.
It's so huge and it's so wonderful to see our culture embracing that approach more and more today. It is looking at what we're eating, what we're putting into our bodies, the source of that food, how we're handling and managing our athletic pursuit, our confinement in the stalls.
So it's both for horses and for humans?
Yes, okay. Yes, the mental outlook. It is holistic. It means W-H-O-L-E, not just H-O-L-I-S-T-I-C. It's a whole program.
Whole big thing.
Yeah.
Which kind of the ball kind of symbolizes
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's good.
I don't know if you planned it that way,
no,
but it kind of works out. Well, what Diana was telling me that you're involved with now fascinates us, because we've had some success actually with it, just experimenting on our own, and that's aromatherapy. Mm. How did you get into that?
Okay, well, Linda Tellington-Jones, who we all love and adore and appreciate so much for everything she's contributed to the horse world, started doing massage therapy and the mouth massage and showing us how to release endorphins, which is just a real positive chemical shift in the brain. And I was using that technique and thought, wow, wouldn't this be great if I could get the lavender that makes me feel so good into the horse's nostrils in addition to this endorphin release. And I started talking to an aromatherapist in Boulder, and we put together a recipe of analgesic effect plant essences that then you actually rub into the horse's nostrils and then continue with the mouth massage. And I am just seeing tremendous results with calming the brain and focusing the horse's mind on his work. Then you just start rubbing up into the nostrils so that all of the oil blend gets into his skin and up into his nasal passage into his brain. And that's where I really want to see it go to work. Now you're also going to see the same thing on the other side, but you know horses are double-sided and you've got to go to both sides and do the same thing. So I'm doing the same thing now on the left as I did on the right. Reg loves his oils. You can tell he's yawning, licking, chewing. He loves his oils. Oh, it smells so good. You know, it's like lavender, basil, neroli, petitgrain, sesame oil. What's not to love about that, right? Okay, make sure you massage his muzzle with the oils. A lot of horses hold their emotions there, and this will get them to release those emotions. And you could spend about 10, 15 seconds doing this, just to make sure you get that oil blend going up, up, up into his nostrils. Okay, and then I just let him rest.
Now, I think of analgesic, I think of that as a fancy word for a painkiller.
Yeah.
Is that what that means?
It's definitely release of anxiety, stress relief, could be pain reliever because horses, you know, may have little incidents of pain that they can't tell us about in any other way. And this would be a way to just kind of ease them out of it. And what's beautiful is they learn to self-release over time when they get the odor of this particular oil blend that I promote.
So it triggers something in their brain from recognizing the aroma?
And what's even better is they associate you, the deliverer of the aromatherapy, as
a spillover benefit for the human. Yeah.
So when my horse sees me coming, he knows that's what he's going to get. And he's like, oh, thank you, Mary, you know.
Now, you mentioned lavender. What is so special about lavender? I think of that as a color, but it's also a plant, isn't it? And it has an aroma to it. What's special about lavender?
Boy, that's hard to explain. It's individual to individual, but it seems to have a universal relaxing effect. It sends you to another place. It's like, and I've been reading that smell is the least understood of all of our senses. They haven't quite figured out yet how the scent gets to the brain and then interpret it into something.
Mm-hmm.
But lavender seems to take us to a calming place. It seems to do something that makes us feel really good and peaceful.
Now we're talking about the horse's sense of smell. I immediately also think of that flamen response where they kind of curl their lip, kind of looks like they're smiling. Can you connect that in any way with the effect of lavender?
That's a really good insight on your part. Yes, it can block pheromones, and that's what you're talking about. The pheromone that the stallion would smell or the mare would smell to indicate a horse in heat or a horse ready to breed or indicating something that would translate to a herd movement or a herd response. And yes, the lavender, basil, neroli, petitgrain, sweet marjoram, sesame, and almond oil that my blend is, definitely can block the pheromones. So if you want your stallion to be nice and calm around mares, you could use this, and that's another benefit.
And you just kind of put it inside his nose?
I do. I have a DVD that shows how you wipe out the nostrils to take any debris or particulates out, and then you just start massaging it right into the nostrils. And you will get a different response from horse to horse. Some of them are fine with it. Some of them are like, do not touch my nose, get out of my nose. And that usually tells me that they're irritable in some way or that they've been holding their emotions in their jaw and in their face.
Yeah.
Just like people do with clenching their teeth or grinding their teeth. They just aren't thinking about it and they kind of do it unconsciously from stress.
Yeah.
And horses are the same. So I really want to get in there and give them some tough love, so to speak, and get the aromatherapy up into the nostrils.
And once they find it doesn't hurt and that it's actually kind of enjoyable, does that make them easier to work with?
It does.
Yeah.
It definitely does. They look forward to it. They get a hint of that smell, and they're just, you know, really expecting something positive to happen.
Now, do you ever have anybody that just says, ooh, that's too gross, I don't want to be sticking my fingers?
I haven't yet.
It's most horse people kind of come to grips with that pretty quick. After you've shoveled enough manure, you figure, you know.
Right.
It's all part of life.
Yes.
Coming up next, Mary Midkiff demonstrates how acupressure can help horses.
Calming horses down and also settling mares.
And we get more expert advice on horse nutrition from Dr. Judy Reynolds.
As their teeth wear, as they get older, sometimes they lose the ability to eat hay and then pasture.
Stay with us. Monitor her.
Go wild. Go super wild. Fly protection goes high fashion with the Supermask 2 Horsefly Mask with Shimmerweave Mesh. Shimmerweave Mesh reflects your horse's natural color. Choose from four fabulous fashion-forward styles. Go wild with the Supermask 2 Horsefly Mask with Shimmerweave Mesh Color Collection.
And the main brand that I only remember was Red Brand. And I can vouch for you, that's what this wire is. And it was put up sometime in 1933 and early for 34. There used to be an old saying made by Red Brand: horse high, bull stout, and hog tight.
I was looking for a riding buddy, and ACTHA helped me find one.
Debbie used ACTHA's Find a Buddy program.
Nobody wants to ride alone. Find a Buddy is a great way to share the fun of trail riding and build a riding community.
Find a Buddy is a free service from ACTHA. Membership is not required. Visit ACTHA.us.
So, find a buddy.
And let's ride.
Build community with the American Competitive Trail Horse Association. ACTHA.us. Imagine a warehouse with everything for your horse. That's Jeffers Equine. Jeffers is the best equine catalog with more than 25,000 items, same day free shipping, the happiest customers, and the lowest prices guaranteed. Save big on a year's supply of apple flavored dewormers, just $29.99. Call 1-800-JEFFERS or visit jefferseequine.com to get your free catalog. Equine specialists are standing by. Jeffers Equine, earning your trust right here in America since 1975. With her focus exclusively on women and horses, Mary Midkiff has carved out an impressive niche in the American horse industry. Aromatherapy is one of her most interesting hands-on tools, and it works as well for young horses as older horses.
You can see she's not quite as willing as Reg, but we've only been doing this for a couple of days. Get up into her nostrils with the oils, and then I start stroking the corners of her mouth with my hands, and she goes right down, and I go right down with her. Good. Now I go right underneath the muzzle and start massaging her gums, just like I did with Reg, and we get a big yawn. Oh, that is so what I'm looking for. Nice release of tension, energy, anything she might be holding on to. Now the thumb and the upper palate. And now playing the piano, again, stretching and stretching those jaw muscles. Good girl. And then I'm gonna go around to the other side, and I'm just gonna start the same process. And remember, some horses are a little more hesitant about you fooling around with their nose and their mouth than others. And again, it's where they hold their tension. It's an emotional point. So get in there with your aromatherapy. Get in there with your massages. Good, good. She's really letting me have this. Really helping her. Let go of any emotions or fears she might be having. And then I'm gonna rub her muzzle. And I'm gonna go into her upper gum. There we go, that was a big breath. That was so awesome, sweetie.
How does acupressure figure into what you do?
Okay, so I integrate the aromatherapy and massage and acupressure into, again, a whole series of releases. So I want to release endorphins, I want to release tension, stress, and sometimes horses that hold their stress, like I said, in the mouth or the jaw will have sore TMJ joints, which are right above the eye socket.
Oh, okay.
So I am massaging up the face and really getting into those jaw muscles, doing some massage there, and then I start doing acupressure around the TMJ joint and holding, and you will just see the horse let go and release and relax.
You can go right up the muscles of the TMJ joint. This is the horse's jaw joint right here. And you go into those muscles, stroking and stroking, and then into an acupressure point right underneath the jaw. And hold there for 10, 20, 30 seconds, however long you can. And you're giving about maybe an ounce of pressure. It's not much, and it does vary from horse to horse. Reg, you can see, is just kind of going into la-la land here, and I need him to do that in order for him to focus with me. Okay, and horses always see you, too, as somebody that can give them this great feeling of relaxation. They like to see you coming. Okay, then we take it from the TMJ point up to the eye socket, and again, I'm putting two fingers into the eye socket, and just giving him about an ounce of pressure, and you can see right away the licking and chewing, the sleepy eye, lowering the head. There you go. Now you can really see the effect of it. Okay, now I'm gonna go back behind the ears about 4 inches down from the main line, so about 6 inches back and about 4 inches down. And this is called triple heater 16, that's this point. And it's very effective on calming horses down and also settling mares that may be really agitated hormonally. And this is a very, very powerful point, very powerful. So when he stretches like that, I really know that he is releasing quite a bit of energy. There you go, you can see the licking and chewing. And I'm giving a little more than an ounce this time. I'm giving more like maybe an ounce and a half. And it's, again, a very powerful point. Good. Sneeze is a release also. Good boy. Okay, then I do a little bit of a massage after the point has been activated. And I let him be for a minute because the horse needs to process this and think for just a minute. Let him be.
What is the observable reaction of the horse? What do you see?
There are many. Lowering the head, licking and chewing, blinking, sleepy eyes, yawning, flexing like this, the jaw. Twitching the ears, maybe a shake or two of released energy, maybe even an impulsive jerk of the head. Just, it's constantly like letting go of the iceberg and melting into water. Just see them constantly releasing. And it's so rewarding that we have that ability just naturally in our hands and with the oils and then your technique.
So through your DVD, can people learn to do this themselves?
Yes.
You show them how to manipulate.
I do it with a filly, a yearling filly, right out of the field that hasn't been handled, and I also do it with my horse.
Okay, I'm going to play the role of the skeptic.
Okay.
I would guess this would kind of fall broadly in the category of alternative medicine or alternative therapies.
Yes.
What do you say to people that say, that's just a bunch of hogwash?
Well, I have to...
Or do you just give up?
No.
You say, if that's how you feel, I can't change your mind.
I usually put the oil blend right under their nose.
Hold them and down
say,
and stuff it in.
Take a whiff. And when they smell that, I see an automatic light bulb.
They can feel a change.
It can calm the person
as
well. Now, my oil blend is diluted 30% for the horse. And we typically want a 10% dilution for the human. So I tell them to use just a tiny bit because it is pretty powerful. and put it on your pulse points.
Oh, you don't put it in your own nose.
And here too.
Oh, okay. Now, what's the significance of putting it on pulse points?
Well, it will immediately go into the skin, into the membranes of the skin, and start getting into the bloodstream. And those are, again, effective plant essences with those oils will go right in there and start doing a number on the whole body.
How did you discover this? I mean, I'm sure you're not the first one that's figured this out.
No, there are other people definitely that have essential oil blends. It's a matter of just, you know, putting it together with what the horse needs, wants, and what you see working, and just keep triggering in your mind, well, you know, that feels really good. It smells great. It's working for people. Let's see what it does for the horse. I know people that use it on dogs and other animals, and so I just had to make sure it was veterinary approved when we started with this. And it's just been a wonderful tool to add to your grooming kit and your regimen.
Well, it is so nice to catch up with you after all these years.
Thanks, great to see you too.
And I know we're not gonna leave here without some of that essential oil. Diana's been really excited about it, so best of luck to you.
Thanks.
It's time to ask the expert about nutrition. Hi, I'm Rick Lamb, along with Dr. Judy Reynolds, equine nutritionist, ADM Alliance Nutrition. And this is Susie Barichka and Sienna. Hi, Susie.
Hi.
Tell us all about Sienna.
Well, Sienna is an 18-year-old national show horse mare, and we do a lot of trail riding and showing.
What are you currently feeding her?
Well, she gets 2 scoops of grain per feeding, and she's out on pasture 24/7, and then hay is supplemented as needed.
Any particular problems with her?
She's a picky eater.
All right, Dr. Reynolds, this is a tough one. If Sienna were your horse, how would you feed her?
Well, Sienna does have some challenges. Being 18, she's what we'd call middle-aged, and she's needing a little bit more feed in order to keep the weight on that you want her to have. And so we have a product called Senior Glow. It's a little bit different than a typical senior feed because it's a concentrate. You feed 6 pounds a day, but it's high in fat. It's got 8% fat. So I think 6 pounds of Senior Glow would be about right for her. You're going to maintain the 24/7 pasture. That's great. As long as she can eat pasture, as their teeth wear as they get older, sometimes they lose the ability to eat hay and then pasture. So monitor her closely. You can increase hay also, as much as she'll eat. I think the Senior Glow is extremely palatable. Very unlikely that she's gonna have any issues with eating that. And I think it'll be a good treat for. So another thing that we'd like to do is, we have a mineral block called Grow Strong Minerals. It's 1/3 salt, but it's 2/3 other extra vitamins and minerals. Same kind of thing as in the Senior Glow. But this way, just like if they need extra salt, they'll go to the block, they would just do this instead. So two things, the Grow Strong Minerals and then 6 pounds of Senior Glow, and just maintain your pasture and hay. I think it'll do real well for you.
All right, Dr. Reynolds, thank you. Mm-hmm. What do you think, Susie?
Sounds great. Thank you.
Well, thank you so much, and thank you, Sienna. To learn more about ADM Alliance Nutrition, visit growstrong.com. That's growstrong.com.
In the coming months, Rick will appear at these events, and he'd like to meet you. Up-to-the-minute details are available at thehorseshow.com. Thehorseshow.com is also a great way to listen to Rick's radio shows or buy signed copies of his books. There's something new for horse lovers every week at thehorseshow.com.
Horses need grain.
Not true. Research has shown that equine grain-associated disorders can be a threat to domestic horses. That's why Glow for Life feeds from ADM Alliance Nutrition go against the grain with premium low-starch, high-fat, high-fiber formulations to feed horses the way they're meant to eat, for life. For a limited time, get a free customized feeding plan for your horse at growstrong.com. That's growstrong.com. Studies have shown that the higher the body temperature, the quicker an athlete reaches fatigue. That's why pro football players use protective padding that's not only shock-absorbing, but lightweight and breathable to allow heat dissipation. Now the same technology is available for your horse. Professional's Choice Air Ride saddle pads are designed with exactly the same material, which allows your horse to remain cool and performing at its maximum while effectively deflecting shock. Try the Air Ride today. Go to profchoice.com and click Rick Lamb.
When customers talk, Richie listens. And the Omni 10 automatic waterer has just what customers want. Extra size and strength, total heat coverage, large access panel, stainless steel trough, and Richie's famous fast refill valve.
Like all Ritchie Waters, the Omni 10 is durable, reliable, and comes with a 10-year warranty. Learn more at richiefount.com. And relax. Ritchie Waters them right.
You want to click the behavior you want to see more of.
Next week, I learn how to use a clicker and a target to train horses.
Very good.
My guest is Shauna Karash.
Okay, let's do our cha-cha now. And up, and back, and up.
So have fun, ride safely, and I'll see you next time. For The Horse Show, I'm Rick Lamb. It's kind of like another organ that they've got, that Flemon organ. Do you have any insights on that? I know, excuse me, my nose is driving me crazy. No, I was just itching.
It's probably the mold from the leaves or something.
Anyway, I've got flying hands in that. And also, think about tipping the top of the head toward the...
Okay. Are we okay up to that point? Can we just pick it up and roll it? Still rolling? Okay. Okay.
Closed captioning is presented by Muddy Creek Rain Gear. Lightweight, breathable, and truly waterproof. Visit muddycreek.net.